वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज शफीक अहमद एंड यू आर ऑल वेलकम टू योर फेवरेट YouTube चैनल, लेट्स लर्न टुगेदर।
सो अ वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू द क्लास एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द सेकंड चैप्टर ऑफ सिविक्स, दैट इज कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल डिजाइन, दैट इज द डिजाइन ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल, हाउ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन इज फ्रेम्ड, है ना, and who comes to frame over their constitution, who frames constitution. So all this we are going to discuss in the chapter. And as you can see in the cover page of the chapter, I have given three images over here: Bhim Rao Ramji Ambedkar, Nelson Mandela, and even Jawaharlal Nehru. So they are the people really involved in making the constitution, and even we will go through a lot of about our constitution as well as the constitution of one other country also, that is South Africa, in the chapter. So we will start the chapter with the conditions of South African people. You might also have heard that there was a lot of chaos and a lot of protest in South Africa regarding the whites and the non-whites, and the people were fighting with each other. So we will start from there only our chapter. So that is the beginning. But before that, we will recap few things from our first chapter also. What is democracy and why democracy? Let us get a brief idea about democracy that we have learned from the previous chapter. That is a brief idea so that we can come to the conclusion. We can recap, we can refresh our minds that what we have learned there. What we have learned in the first chapter, that in a democracy, the rulers are not free to do. In a democracy, I'm talking about democracy, because the rulers are elected by the people, and these rulers are not free to do what they want to do, what they want to do, what they like, because they are accountable. They will have to give us the accounts, details of the accounts and details of their work also. They will have to respond to the queries of the citizen of the country also. So in a democracy, the rulers are never free to do what they used to do, what they like. So there is a foundation, they have to answer to the people. Next, what we have recapped in the first chapter, what we have discussed, learned that the citizens as well as the government have to follow certain basic rules. And really, there must be some rules and regulations to be followed by everyone also. So even the government, that is the rulers, and even the citizens have to follow some basic rules. And all those such rules have put together in a book, you know, have been put together, and they are known as the constitution of the country. And the constitution of the country is not only followed by the citizens, but also it is followed by the government also, the rulers also. They will also have to abide by the rules and regulations, whatever which is written in the constitution. So all the rules, you know, which are there for the citizens as well as the government, those rules are known as the constitution over here. Put together, all those such rules are put together, and they are called as constitution. So what the constitution determines, what it says, and let us see, if there is a question in the exam, you can answer the from here, this paragraph. The constitution determines the rights of the citizens. It says about the rights of the citizen. Constitution says, and it speaks up about the right of the citizens, about the powers of the government, you know, what the government has the power and how the government should function. It is also written, clearly mentioned in the constitution, which is also known as the supreme law of the country. The constitution is the supreme law. Likewise, we have the Supreme Court in our country. So likewise, in the same way, the constitution is the supreme law of the country. Means no one is above constitution, no one is above this supreme law. Everyone will have to abide by the rules and the regulations, whatever it is written in the constitution, and that is regarded as the supreme law. Means law for all. So let us see, you might have got the answer of the what the constitution determines. Even the constitution provides a good framework, a structure, how to conduct, you know, how to live your life. You can see over here, the constitution provides a structure or a framework, good framework for the conduct of the citizen's life, how the citizen of the country should behave and how should they conduct their life, and even how the government should work. even it is that it is also mentioned in the constitution, that of the government, the conduct not only of the citizen's life but of the government, and what should be the conduct of the government as well as what should be the conduct of the citizen's life, how the citizens should behave for their country, in the country, all the things are mentioned and a framework is given, a structure is given in the constitution. And those structure are also known as preamble of the constitution also, that we will deal in the later part of the chapter. So now we will come to the democratic constitution in South Africa. As I told you that we will start the chapter by going through the constitution or the development of the constitution in South Africa, how it happened. So before going through that, we will have to understand about this man, Nelson Mandela, what he said and what was his role there in the democratic constitution in South Africa. What is he doing over here? Let us see his quote, what he has quoted. He has quoted that, "I have fought against white domination." White domination means the white people, means those who were fair in color in South Africa. They are denoted over here as the white people. So he is saying, Nelson Mandela is saying over here that, "I have fought against white domination and as well I have fought against black domination also." Means the people who are black in color, those who are black, he's talking about themselves also. He's talking about them also, that I have fought against the domination of anyone, whether he is black or white. No one should dominate on another. Dominate ka matlab koi kisi par havi nahi hona chahiye. Everyone should be equal, he's saying. "I have cherished the ideal of a democratic and free society," he's saying further. That he really enjoyed the ideas of the democratic and the idea of the free society, in which all persons live together in harmony with peace, and even all persons live together with equal opportunities. So he wants to enjoy, and he has enjoyed these ideas of democratic country and the society which is free, where all peoples are living together in harmony with peace and with equal opportunities. So it is his thinking. And further he is saying, "It is an ideal which I hope to live for and to achieve also." Now that is the twist over here. He's saying that he hoped to live for these things, for free society where people will live in harmony and with equal opportunities, and he wants to achieve that also, because it was not there in his country, in South Africa. That's why he has added that he wanted to achieve that also. And you can see over here, next further he says, "But if he needs be, it is an ideal for which I am prepared to die." Now he's saying that to achieve this, to get the free society where people will live in harmony and equal opportunities, for that he is ready to die also. He's saying that, "I am prepared to die also for that. If someone will take my life and will ask me that, if you are ready to give your life, then I am also ready to give you all this society where people can live together in harmony and with equal opportunities," then he's saying that, "I am ready for that. I will give my life for this." So that was the quote, and that was the, you can say, activity also that he was doing in South Africa. And for that also he received punishment also in South Africa. And you will really feel embarrassing, and you will cry, because when you will learn about his punishment, what type of punishment he got, let me discuss that also. So as we have gone through the ideas of Nelson Mandela, what was his thinking, what he was ready to die also, we have gone through. So you can see over here that Nelson Mandela being tried for treason. Treason means desh se desh ko dhoka dena, or you can say desh drohi. That he was charged for that particular charge, and treason. Treason, I have written the meaning also, the offense of attempting to overthrow the government of the state. Means if you are trying, treason means that you are trying to overthrow the government, the current government. So Nelson Mandela was charged for this particular crime, or you can it was not actually a crime, but it was the thinking of the whites. And they were thinking that Nelson Mandela is going against the government by saying all these things, by having this type of thinkings. So you can see over here Nelson Mandela being tried for treason, for treason by the white South African government. So South Africa was having a government of the white only. So and Nelson Mandela was trying to create a society, to get a society where people can live in harmony altogether and enjoy peace, and even they can have equal opportunities. So because he was against the government, against the thinking of the government, so he was arrested for that. He and seven other leaders were sentenced to life imprisonment in the year 1964. Go through this, that they were given sentenced to life imprisonment, yani ki unko pure zindagi ke liye jo hai imprisonment diya gaya tha. Life imprisonment in 1964 for daring. For what? For daring to oppose. Oppose means to go against the apartheid government in his country. Apartheid government that we will discuss later on, just after a few minutes, that the government which was going on in South Africa, which was running, that was they were following apartheid system of government. That is a system of government that I will discuss later on. So Nelson Mandela just was charged, and he and along with his seven other leaders also, they were all sent to jail, or you can say they were all sent behind the bar for in the year 1961 for their lifetime. And for what was their crime, what was their fault? They opposed, and they go away, they went against the government, they went against the South African government, which was also regarded as apartheid. So he spent the next 28 years. That is the thing, you have to just imagine. For the next 28 years, it is not 2 years, it is not 8 years, it is 28 years, my dear student, that he went along with other seven leaders for 28 years in jail. And it was really most dreaded prison, Robben Island. And what was the name of the prison? Robben Island was the name of the prison in South Africa, where he, along with his other leaders, was sent for imprisonment for next 28 years. Just you can, 28 years of your life. This is one of the photograph, image from that particular prison. Robben Island, and you can see Nelson Mandela just standing there for his thinking, for opposing the government. He was sent behind the bar for the next 28 years. So that was really dreadful. That is really very the thing that we don't like in our life. So let us see struggles against apartheid. Now we will go through the meaning, the word apartheid over here. Okay, apartheid was the name of a system of racial discrimination unique to South Africa. So it is a system of what? Discrimination. And discrimination on the basis of race, on the basis of color over here, the white and the black. The fight was for the color of the people. So it was a system which was just promoting discrimination or racial discrimination in South Africa, which was really unique in South Africa. It was the official policy of the government to separate, or you can say segregation, and alag alag baantna logon ko. So it was the official policy of the racial separation. And separate karte hain kaise? On the basis of the race. Or ye race mein color bhi aa sakta hai. The color is also there in the differentiation of races. So it was the official policy of the racial separation and ill treatment of blacks. So the South African government were not doing good treatment. They were ill treatment. They were treating the blacks in a very bad manner. So apartheid, that was the official policy of the government to separate the people according to their races, according over here, according to their color over here. Followed by the government of South Africa between 1948 and 1989. This was the time when the system, apartheid system, was followed in South Africa, and you can see it is long, and from 1948 to 89, and almost it is more than 50 years. So the white Europeans imposed this system on South Africa. White Europeans, they were having, they formed the government and they imposed this system of racial separation. Means the racial separation over here, even the people of South Africa were having different trains, different hospitals, having different schools, different colleges for different color of the people. Means white will go into this hospital and the black will go to another hospital. White can travel only this on this train, black will travel all, black can travel on other train and other trains. So there was a segregation system, separation in the common conduct of the life also. During the 17th and the 18th centuries, the trading companies from Europe occupied it with arms and force in the way they occupied India. So it is clearly mentioned over here, like the Europeans have occupied in India with the help of their arms and force. So likewise, the white over there in South Africa, you know, they have also occupied, especially the trading companies. Trading companies, yes, we know the Britishers also came to India for trading purpose only. Only the British East India Company was there and it was a trading company who later on occupied the whole India. So that was the same thing happened in South Africa also. So the whites were involved in trading, you know, they were having big trading companies and they, with the help of arms and force, they really occupied South Africa and they were dominating the white. The whites were dominating on the non-whites, on the black, or the non-whites, or you can say the blacks. Unlike India, a large number of whites had settled in South Africa and became the local rulers. So it is not matching with India. Okay, a large number of whites had settled, a large number of Britishers have not settled in India. They were ruling on us with our help, with our only facilities that we have provided to them. They have ruled on us with our effort also, because we, the Indians, helped the Britishers to rule on us. And you will later learn a lot about that in the first chapter, or it is in the third chapter of class 10. So let's come to the point over here that the whites were not in large number. The whites were not in large number in South Africa. So a large number of whites, they have settled in South Africa. They become the common rulers. They become the local rulers and they were just dominating on the non-white people. You can see the system of apartheid was the system to divide the people and level them on the basis of their skin colors. That I was talking about, that apartheid is a system to divide the people, to segregate the people, to divide and to separate them on the basis of what? On the basis of their skin color, whites and the non-whites. That was the official system that was followed in South Africa during that time. So that is really amazing that how can a country divide people on the basis of the color. So that was really not good for the South African government. And a lot of people went against that particular apartheid system also. And Nelson Mandela was one of them. And we have just discussed that really what he has faced and his leaders for that effort, for that opposition. What they opposed, they were sent to imprisonment for the long 28 years. So, my dear,
hope that you have liked the video, and we will meet again in our next video release of the tutorial. And if you are new to this channel, please subscribe the channel and press the bell icon to get the information of the next release of the tutorial. Please share it with your friends and others also. Thank you for the time being. Take care. Stay at home. Bye-bye. Take care.